family guy actually done the trilogy of Star Wars, and just recently, like yesterday, the last one came out. But I actually have all of them. The first one that I have, this one over here, is Blue Harvest. And this is the first one, and I have the special edition that comes with a t-shirt. I actually showed this before. I showed the t-shirt that comes with 3D glasses and cards. One of the really funny, really love this. The second one, which is something dark side. This one is on the Empire Strikes Back. I wasn't able to get the special edition because the special edition was on Blu-ray, and I didn't have a Blu-ray on that time, and I do now. So that is why yesterday I went to get It's a Trap. It is the latest Family Guy spin on Star Wars, and this one is based on Return of the Jedi. Really funny. And of course, the ultimate spoof of all time, Mel Brooks' Space Wars. I actually went to see this movie in the theaters. I actually went like 2 or 3 times to see it. I haven't seen anyone do a great spoof like this one. If this movie were a fan film, it would be the master of all fan films. It is completely awesome. Mel Brooks, he actually likes to spoof other stories. I have done a great job with this one. Completely awesome. Many people were actually expecting to see a sequel to this movie. And when the new prequels to Star Wars came out, there was a rumor going around that a sequel was coming, but it was going to be a prequel to Spaceballs, which actually never came, and what they did is the Spaceballs cartoons, which wasn't very funny at all. I didn't actually like it. I'm a huge fan of Spaceballs, but Spaceballs cartoons, actually, I didn't like them at all. So,
I always have coffee when I watch Radar. You know that.
Of course I do, sir.
Everybody knows that.
Of course we do, sir.
Hey, Vidium, how you doing? This is Star Wars Nut 77. Thank you for having me on your show. I greatly appreciate it. And you'd asked me a while ago what my favorite Star Wars video game moment is. And to be honest with you, it's kind of tough because I had to think about it because there's so many Star Wars games I absolutely love. My favorite Star Wars video game of all time is the Atari Star Wars Arcade stand-up. And even the cockpit one where you sit down, man, that's awesome. But as far as my favorite Star Wars video game moment, man, that's really tough. That's a loaded question, bro. I would have to go with this because I think about it as far as nostalgic reasons. This is it right here. X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. This is for the PC. Played this a lot on Windows 95 on my Gateway computer with my brother. There was no online gaming back in the day, and during this time anyway. So him and I would play this a lot. This is a cocktail-style shooter, kind of like Wing Commander. If you guys have played Wing Commander and you love Star Wars, definitely check this series out. There's X-Wing, there's also TIE Fighter, and there's X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. So I think there's a couple other ones in the series as well, but this is an awesome game, Star Wars fans, so check it out. I appreciate you having me on your show, Vidium. Thank you very much. And may the Force be with you too, always. Take care.
get pickups for the month, and I'm gonna start with this Epic Mickey Collector's Edition. I saw this on Kmart and I just had to buy it because I wanted this little guy over here. I just love fairies and I saw this and I was like, I gotta have it. I haven't played the game yet. It's really fun, you know, the parts that I have played, but I haven't really finished it yet. I'm gonna get into it later on. Probably make a review. Here's the game. Yeah. Really fun, you know, but I'm gonna review it later on. Yeah. Stay tuned on Facebook for that. I also got myself Michael Jackson, The Experience. Really fun dance game. I bet you always saw me dancing, shaking it on Best Buy over there. Yeah, really funny. And it also brought the glove. I wanted that. Really awesome. I also got, yeah, I got myself a PS3. And I got Bayonetta. Really fun action game. I got it for like $18. Really cheap, really amazing. I installed it. The load times are hell. I also got the fighting game Blaze Blue or Blast Blue or whatever it's called. Continuum Shift. Really fun fighting game from the creators of Guilty Gear. That's why I love it so much. Though the last boss is killing me. I really hate him. And I also got, obviously, Super Street Fighter 4. Really amazing, kicking ass online. Check it out, you know. And if you got, what? Okay, if you got a PS3 ID, you know, hook it up with me, Nookie-kun, or whatever, you know, we're gonna put that on later. And here it is, the sexy PS3. Mm-hmm. I got it. What about you?
Well, guys, it's my time to show you my pickups for the month. And as you know, I also picked up, just like Nookie, a PlayStation 3. I finally have one. I know that many of you are saying, yeah, finally, he has a PS3. With the PS3, I actually picked up two games. So the first one that I picked up with the system is actually Super Street Fighter 4, brand new, and I was dying to play this game. As you know, I'm a huge fighting game fan, and I am a huge Street Fighter fan, and I wasn't able to sink my teeth on this game. Two versions already out, Street Fighter 4, Super Street Fighter 4, and I haven't been able to play it very well. I just played a few times in my brother-in-law's house. But now I'm going to be able to practice on this one. I also got a new router, so now I'm online, so I'm going to be able to play online. So all of you that actually want to play with me, I'm going to be available. I'm going to be giving you my code pretty soon. For the PlayStation 3 is Vidium X. Vidium is my name, and the X at the end. Another game that I picked up is Resistance Fall of Man. I actually bought this used on GameStop for, I believe it was $9.99. The reason why I picked up this game, I'm not very good in shooters. I have said it many times over that I'm a really bad shot. I'm a very lousy shot. But the reason why I actually picked up this game is that I played the PSP version. And the PSP is very different from this one, but I liked it very much, and I liked the story on Resistance. And I just saw the visuals on Resistance too, and I fell in love with it. So I said, I'm gonna have to give it a try. I've been playing it, and it's not that hard, actually. I'm getting good at it. But I really loved it, so I'm gonna give it a twirl, see how it actually goes. A friend of mine was on vacation this past week. He was on the States, and he actually saw this, and every time that he sees anything that is Star Wars related, he has to bring me one. So he actually picked this for me. It's a three-set puzzle pack from the Clone Wars. He actually has one with Anakin and the Clone Troopers, Anakin, Ahsoka, and Obi-Wan with the Clone Troopers. I don't know if I'm gonna open this, but it's pretty cool, actually. Another thing that I got, I actually got this from my mom. She saw it and she said, I have to buy it. And it is a 2011 calendar from Star Wars. And it's the complete saga. And there are actually posters. He actually has posters from the complete saga. Each one is a poster. It looks awesome. $12.99 Kmart. I haven't opened it yet. I'm trying to find out where I can actually put it. It actually looks cool. So, pretty awesome. Another thing that I got here, these are not video games, these are actually DVDs. And the first one that I picked up is Jeff Dunham, Spartan Insanity. I love this man. I love Peanut and I love Ahmed. I've been dying to get one of his DVDs. I had seen his special on Comedy Central and all, but I really wanted to get one and I loved it. Now I'm gonna try to pick old. I believe there are three more or four more, I don't know. I also picked up A Nightmare on Elm Street. This is the original movie, this is not the remake. And I actually bought it because it was only $3.99, brand new, in Walgreens. I bought this in Walgreens. And it's actually is a two-disc set. And I know that this game, this movie actually comes in a package with the other movies and those DVD package that brings four movies. He has the first four Nightmare on Elm Street all together. But I just saw it and I gotta have it. It's just $3.99, so I picked it up. I also picked up Turbulence on Walgreens for $3.99 also, completely new. And I actually picked this one up because of the cover. Kill the Shogun. I haven't seen it, so I don't know much about this. Also $3.99. In video games, I haven't picked up that much. Just PlayStation 3 games. And I also picked up the Michael Jackson Experience for the Nintendo Wii. This is actually my wife's. But we actually picked that up with the Michael Jackson glove replica. Pretty awesome. And as you all know, I also picked up the 25th anniversary edition of Super Mario All Stars. I already showed this to all of you, but what the hell? One more time, just.
There is no escape. Don't make me destroy you.